When you've got a job to do, go with a winner. True Value Hardware Store. Seal up to 5 windows drum tight with the 3M window insulator kit, just $9.99. Get a bonus roll of Scotch 35mm film. Brighten areas with GE75 or 150-watt floodlights, only $2.44 each. And clean up dry debris or wet spills with the Hoover Double Duty Hand Vac, just $29.99. And make True Value Hardware your store first choice.
Milwaukee Brewers. For season ticket information, call 933-1818. The magic continues.
Buick's Best presents Bucks and Ducks. Get big bucks back on Skylark, Century, LeSabre Wagon, or Electra Park Avenue. Use your bucks as a down payment or get cash back. Duck in today for Bucks and enter Buick's Best Greater Milwaukee Duck Race. Adopt a duck for only $5. Grand prize this 1989 Buick Rayana. Enter and participate in Hardee's, Century Foods, and Buick's Best Dealer.
For spectacular 2-4 savings on everything in the store.
Make it strong, make it strong.
The 2-4 sale's on now.
In the top of the fourth inning, Robin Yount will lead it off. Then Deer and Leonard against the lefty Ken Patterson, who has settled down since the first. He gave up a leadoff homer to Molitor and then an inside the park home run to Robin. That has been it. Brewers leading 2-0. Only 2 base hits for Milwaukee. The home runs by Molitor and Yount. And 1 hit for the White Sox. Tapper back to the mound. Patterson, whoa, he threw a lollipop over there to the first baseman, Diaz. They get Yount, but it didn't look very pretty. Along our network tonight, WMSN, TV 47 in Madison, WGBA, TV 26, Green Bay, WLAX, TV 25 in La Crosse, and our Florida stations tonight, WPGX, TV 28, Panama City, and WFGX, TV 35, Fort Walton Beach. Did he go around? No, says Jim Evans at first base, breaking ball in the dirt from Patterson. Of course, our flagship station, Super 18 in Milwaukee. Hope you're enjoying the telecast tonight as the 1988 season comes to a close. Boy. After tonight, the Brewers with 16 to go, 15 to go, 16 including tonight. That's right. Two and one to Deer. Rob leads the ball club in home runs with 21. Robin Yount with his 77th run batted in to lead the Brewers in that department. 3-1, again in the dirt to Deer. Outfield straight away and deep for Rob Deer. In the dirt, gets away from Fisk. Deer will hold it first. First walk issued by Patterson. And Carlton Fisk, is that his first trip to the mound tonight? Well, I think he went out after a home run.
He went out with Fregosi.
But he wears a path between that pitching mound and home plate. Patterson is just 24 years old and only in his fourth year of professional baseball. Outside. A ball and no strikes on Jeffrey Leonard. One out. Patterson played his college ball at Baylor in the Southwest Conference. This one fouled back, one and one. The Indians lead New York 4-3 in the sixth inning. Greg Brock waiting on deck. Toronto 5, Detroit 1, also in the sixth. One-one pitch. Looping fly ball, and Diaz can't get to it. Right near the Brewer dugout and the camera bay. Did the cameraman have a shot at that and missed it? Leonard struck out his first time up. Deer at first. Inside. Two balls, two strikes. The Brewers will wind up the season series with the White Sox tomorrow night. And that's on to Seattle after an off day on Thursday. The weekend in Seattle, 2-2 pitch. Got him. Fisk couldn't hold on. It was a breaking ball. Deer got a good jump. It will go as a stolen base for Rob Deer. And the second time tonight, Patterson has gotten Jeffrey Leonard. Deer with a good jump.
And he has an uncontested stolen base. His ninth.
Third strikeout for Patterson. That's the second time, as we said, that he has gotten Jeffrey Leonard. His pattern very, very close to the way Jerry Royce pitched these guys last night, with the exception of two mistakes. 0-2 pitches to Yount and Molitor that went for home runs in the first. Talking to Gordy Lakey, who is a scout for the Toronto Blue Jays on special assignment here. And before the ball game, he said, Royce pitched this ball club about as good as you can pitch them last night. 1-0 pitch inside with a breaking ball, one ball, one strike. He pitched to their weaknesses, didn't throw them good strikes to hit at, and may have thrown a lot of balls that they were swinging at. So why change? And Patterson trying to do the same thing. This one hit on the ground to Manrique. He will make the play at first. Two outs is, or make that retire the side. So for the Brewers here in the fourth, no runs, no hits. One man left. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Milwaukee 2, Chicago nothing on the Brewer Television Network.
Hey, Paul, everyone sings La Bamba, but what does it mean?
Well, buy us all around a Miller Lite, I'll tell you.
Okay. Hey, Mike.
To dance La Bamba, all that you need is a beer with great taste and a nice friend like Billy to pick up the check. Bamba, bamba.
There's only one light beer, Miller Lite.
Can y'all tell me what La Bamba means?
Y'all ask Billy.
Coming Wednesday from the Wisconsin Lottery. The first instant game called Match 3. Just scratch, then merge. mystery of a kind to win. With drawings for $1 million. Next 3 tickets go on sale Wednesday. Look for details wherever the Wisconsin Lottery sign is displayed.
I think the best thing about Midwest Express is the people, their commitment to excellence. Each and every person at Midwest Express, from the ramp people to the pilots to the flight attendants to the reservationists, are committed to making sure that each person is treated individually, and we're out to make sure you have the best flight possible. I think there's a lot of pride in everything we do. The people in Milwaukee deserve service like Midwest Express.
The best care in the air, Midwest Express.
Co-anchors Liz Talbot and Dwayne Gay with Bob Buck Sports and Marlon McGee Weather. Your 9 o'clock nightly news team on Super 18 WZTV Milwaukee.
Bottom of the fourth, and Steve Lyons will lead off for Chicago. The Lyons came into the ball game in the first inning when Robin hit that ball into the gap in right center field. Williams and Gallagher collided, and Williams went out with an injury. So Lyons, a left-handed hitter in the lineup against Nieves, and fouls it back. 1-1. He struck out his first time up. Played third base last night, hitting at 260. Ooh, that jammed him. Say it. The lefties so far in this lineup, Lyons and Guillen, have not had good cuts at Juan's fastball. He's almost doing them a favor, throwing them the breaking ball. Like he's got, there's the breaking ball tapped to first, easy play for Brock, one out. Looks like he has pretty good pop on his fastball tonight. Home runs, 70 runs batted in. The DH, talking about Lyons. He was with the Boston Red Sox. In Milwaukee, Jim, I don't know if you remember this or not, but he was at second base with 2 outs. Wade Boggs at the plate, close ball game, and he stole third on his own and was thrown out.
I remember it because when we were in Boston this summer and Gettman had a bad base running mistake on third base, got caught between home and third, in the paper they referred to him attending the Steve Lyons School of Base Running.
About 2 weeks later, Lyons was traded to Chicago. A ball and 2 strikes on Baines. Juan misses upstairs, 2-2. That is, well, first of all, you don't want to get thrown out stealing third with 2 outs anyway. But try to do it in a close ball game with Wade Boggs at the plate. Count even, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Brewers with a 2-0 lead. Bottom of the fourth. Harold Baines, before the knee injury, really one of the better all-round players in the league. A right fielder. Now pretty much relegated to the DH duties. Ooh, just missed with an off-speed pitch, and that runs the count full. 3 balls and 2 strikes. The sign is set from BJ. He sets up outside. That's where Nieves goes, and he misses. Second walk by Nieves. Chris fly to left his first time up in the second inning. A ball outside. Pretty good career against Milwaukee. 32 home runs lifetime, 109 runs batted in, and a .272 lifetime batting average against the Brewers. Missed with a changeup, 2-0. Nieves making his first start after six relief appearances. First start since July 14th. Good look at B.J. Cirhoff as he gives the sign to Juan. Foul back. 2-1. Of course, Nieves on the disabled list, and then at Denver. Like they want to go with the fastball away to Fisk. He missed inside, but Fisk fouled it off. Two balls, two strikes. Boy, you really get a good look at that close-up camera, don't you? At BJ checking the runner, checking the hitter. I would say that is a changeup. We shall see. It was. Hit on the ground. Molitor will go for one. Gander the relay. Not in time. Throw was high. That ball not hit very hard by Fisk.
Just reached out, got it on the end of the bat, taps it to Molitor. Again, not hit that hard. Molitor cuts in front of Sheffield. Gantner tries to turn the relay, and Fisk beats it out.
See, Gantner with the runner Baines coming in had to take a step almost back or sideways. Jim couldn't get much on it. Baines broke it up. He is retired. So Fisk will be at first base with two outs now. And Diaz, who single to left his first time up and had the game winner last night up there with two outs.
He took extra batting practice last night, paid off with the game winning RBI and a base hit in this ball game, the only hit so far off Diaz.
See that wrist heavily taped, and he's still having problems, as I said earlier, with the thumb. He was saying, Jim, that while he was on the disabled list, 0-1 pitch, hit well, center field, Robin going way back. He will stop at the track and put it away. We'll tell you more about Diaz when we come back. For the White Sox in the fourth, no runs, no hits. They leave one, four complete now at Comiskey. The Brewers two and the White Sox nothing on the Brewer Television Network.
Never have so many paid so much for so little. What America needs, what America needs, is a true honor. America needs is a good, honest cookie.
There you have it. An honest-to-goodness cookie at an honest-to-goodness price. Delicious brand cookies.
By the most exacting of standards, you stand out. You're the best, and your car is no exception. It's simply exceptional. A first-class ticket to automotive luxury. No compromises. The 88 Cressida. It all starts at your Toyota dealer. He'll help with a deal that makes sense for you. Great car, great deal. But you gotta go see him. When you're at the controls, you can afford a great time. So head to your Toyota dealer and ride with the best.
Terry, if you don't want to end up in court,
you better send the child to court.
I'm calling about your son, Grover. You better send money. His ski trip's over.
Send the money now, you dig. Or we won't make our next gig.
To send someone money fast, come to Western Union. We'll make sure it gets to any of our 10,000 locations, usually in 15 minutes or less.
Cruising!
Western Union, the fastest way to send money.
I hate how they wrinkle my suit.
You ought to see my cleaning bill.
No excuses. Seat belts save lives. This is a reminder from your Century Food Store.
Joey Meyer will lead off the fifth. Brewers up to zip on the young left-hander Ken Patterson, making his first major league start. The Red Sox leading Baltimore 5-2 in the seventh. Cleveland 4, New York 3 in the seventh. Toronto 5, Detroit 1 also in the seventh inning. Down low to Meyer. Joey grounded out back in the second inning. Meyer at 273. 11 home runs, 42 runs batted in for Joey. Good cut. One ball, one strike. The Brewers trail New York by a game and Detroit by two. Get on the ground, wide at third, base hit. So Joey Meyer stays hot with the bat. I'll tell you, what a difference in Joey Meyer now that he's playing every day, Jim, from the Joey Meyer we saw playing a couple of times a week or maybe once every 2 weeks early in the year.
Pretty good example right there, stayed on the breaking pitch.
Yep.
He's a very smart hitter.
And he goes to the plate with confidence now, too. Boy, that's a big part of hitting or pitching. Big part of this game, confidence. Good bunt by Surhoff, and there will be no play. Good bunt by BJ, who does that so well. I don't believe that Diaz knew Manrique was at first base.
I was just going to ask. He's looking for Patterson to cover, and he had a man covering. Manrique was camped on the bag. They had a play.
Yep. Really, BJ bunting for a base hit. So, if the sacrifice was on, that second baseman would be covering the pitcher, or the first baseman would take a natural look with the second baseman covering. But I tell you, that was a heads-up play by Manrique. Don Paul, a right-hander in the White Sox bullpen. So runners at first and second. A couple of base hits here in the fifth. Sheffield at the plate, and the White Sox looking for a bunt. Brewers now with four base hits. Sheffield with the green light from Trepp. They are still up at the corners. Martinez at third and Diaz at first. Shortstop, second baseman at double play depth. And he had a good cut. Let's see what Trepp does right now. Oftentimes, and we've seen Trepp do it before, give that hitter an opportunity to swing at one pitch. He fouls it off or doesn't put it in play. He switches and will go to the bunt. He may not. Not want to take the chance with Meyer at second base. And might want to give the youngster a chance to swing the bat, too. Let's see what happens. They are really pulled in now. Diaz way in at first base. He's going to swing away, and he takes a ball down low. A reminder, we'll be picking the Miller Lite Super 18 MVP following tonight's game. $100 in his name donated to the Mac Fund, courtesy of Miller Lite and Super 18. Get on the ground. Nice play by Gian Manrique. Oh, they got two. Boy, that's the one thing that you did not want to have happen. Boy, what a nice double play by Guillen and Manrique.
Well, Sheffield has to be wondering if this is all the White Sox do is turn double plays. They have 165 of them. He has hit into three of them, and he nearly hit into a triple play in Milwaukee.
Yep.
But this is a well-turned 6-4-3.
Boy, and Manrique just held his ground, too, didn't he? So what started out to be a promising inning, now two outs, runner at third, and Paul Molitor at the plate. If Paulie can't come through with a big two-out base hit. Looks at a strike. That is the one problem, Jim, with Joey's speed or lack of it. Looping fly ball, right field. Lyons closes and makes the play. So the Brewers miss an opportunity in the fifth. No runs, two hits, one left. After four and a half, Milwaukee 2, Chicago nothing on the Brewer Television Network.
Brewers. For season ticket information, call 933-1818. The magic continues.
Buick's Best presents Bucks and Ducks. Get big bucks back on Skylark, Century, LeSabre Wagon, or Electra Park Avenue. Use your bucks as a down payment or get cash back. Duck in today for Bucks and enter Buick's Best Greater Milwaukee Duck Race. Adopt a duck for only $5. Grand prize this 1989 Buick Rayana. Enter and participate in Hardy, Century Foods, and Buick's Best Dealer.
This covered the place where you'll always find more. It's Handy Andy, your home improvement superstore.
Discover our big store-wide grand opening sale. Save $50 on the Crystal Classic Storm Door from Lialco. The tempered beveled glass has the rich, distinctive look of crystal, made with a solid wood core for high insulation and strength. Available in white or bronze. 36 by 80 only, right now, just $179.
With Handy Andy, you've got it made.
Joe Piscopo, Danny DeVito, Marilu Henner, and Michael Keaton. Hollywood meets Mr. Mob in Johnny Dangerously.
Friday night at 7, followed by our nightly news.
Russ Moorman will face Nieves here in the fifth. Moorman, Martinez, and Guillen. The first pitch, a breaking ball by Nieves down low. One ball, no strikes on Moorman. Fastball, good pitch, 1-1. That is the problem that you have, Jim, as we talked about with Joey. You almost have to lay down a perfect bunt to get him to third. But if you're able to execute it, Molitor hits the fly ball to right field. That's another run on the board. And the runs have been tough to come by. Nieves working DeMormin, one ball, two strikes. He has allowed the White Sox just one base hit through the first four innings. Popped up near the Brewer dugout. It could be playable for Brock, and it is. Nice play by Brock. Not a whole lot of room in foul territory here.
Seen a couple of fine catches in foul territory tonight. Brock stays with it. Catches it in the doorway there. Earlier in the ballgame of the second, Leonard made a fine catch in foul territory down the left field line.
Here's Carlos Martinez. Base hit center field. So Martinez with the second White Sox hit of the night. A one out single to center field. Martinez has been pretty impressive, has he not? Made some good plays in the field. Solid base hit. He hit 283 at Birmingham in the Southern League. Guillen just gets a piece of the breaking ball from Nieves. He is just 23 years old. Are from the same town in Venezuela, La Guaira. Hit to left. Leonard going back and makes the play. Leonard playing shallow in left field for Guillen. Had to hustle back there to make the catch. Before Manrique comes to the plate, let's pause for station identification here on the Milwaukee Brewer Television Network.
You're watching the Brewers and White Sox on Super 18 WVTV Milwaukee.
Mike Egan, Jim Paschke with you from Comiskey Park in Chicago. A reminder for Milwaukee viewers, stay tuned immediately after tonight's game for the 9 o'clock nightly news, followed by the Tonight Show, which will be seen in its entirety on Super 18. The 9 o'clock nightly news is going to be a bit late tonight, folks, because it's 9:01 already. So hang tight back in the studio. Manrique walked his first time up back in the third inning. You can see why these guys have turned 165 double plays. Talking about Guillen, Manrique, Donnie Hill. Good pitch, off-speed pitch, and Manrique fooled. I'll tell you, though, Guillen is the key. He is so quick.
That's an awful lot of double plays when you consider the fact that the White Sox lead the league in errors.
Well, you keep putting runners on, you got a chance to double them up, don't you?
Well, that's true, too. But you don't know how many double play balls they've mishandled.
He went after a high fastball and strikes out. That is the second strikeout for Juan, and the White Sox out here in the fifth with no runs a hit. They leave one. Five full innings now from Chicago. The Brewers 2, the White Sox nothing on the Brewer Television Network.
It is my pleasure today to introduce to you some of the key staff members of the Century Egg Farm. They're only one day old, but they have an important job: to grow into hens and to lay perfect, grade A eggs for Century. It's the only way to be sure Century brand eggs are truly farm fresh.
Hey, get out of there. Get out of there. You're not fresh enough.
Century brand means good food costs less at Century.
Let in the good return to Century. People ask me if I am so hungry that flamenco dancer was excluded from the Olympic Games. Me? Hungry? No. Which means, of course, at least I can enjoy a great tasting middle night.
To everyone with an Olympic dream, cheers.
Serious shoppers from all over the world are ready and raring to get the Best Buy's Olympic sales. No one competes with our low, low prices. With savings on world-class electronics and appliances, including Panasonic products, like a Panasonic microwave at just $117.99, or a Panasonic vacuum for just $129.99. It's the Olympic sale at Best Buy. A sale this big comes around only once every 4 years.
The Foster View.
Ain't no better time or place to buy a new pond yet.
We'll choose down any deal in town.
One strike on Jimmy Gantner as we move to the sixth. Gantner 0 for 2 tonight. Low ball, one ball, one strike. We will be back with you tomorrow night to finish off this series between the Brewers and the White Sox. Brewers have to win both tonight and tomorrow night to even the season series. They trail the White Sox 6-4. White Sox have won 6. Bill Long and Bill Wegman will match up tomorrow night. This ball hit up the middle. Nice stop by Guillen. Oh, he can do it, can he? Ozzie Guillen has done it again, robbing Gantner of a base hit.
Oh, he's an exciting player, isn't he? This is why the White Sox want to sign him up for a couple of years, long-term deal, and build around an exciting shortstop.
Oh, he is just so smooth out there, isn't he? Even going to his knees as he did, he made it look easy. Robin hit his 12th home run of the year back in the first inning. An inside the park home run to right center field. Gallagher and Williams, Kenny Williams, who was the starting right fielder, colliding out in right center field, and Robin came all the way around the bases.
Robin's batting 304, and I have a question for you. Did you happen to notice that there are only 5 300 hitters in the National League, and I think the last time I looked, 14 in the American League? I can't really figure out a reason for that. They play with the same baseball.
Yeah, they play with the same baseball. They play with more turf over in the National League. That is interesting. Good big breaking ball that time. Nice tight rotation. There's Rob Deere waiting on deck. A lot of, you know, we were talking about this yesterday with Andy Etchebarren and Chuck Hartenstein before the ball game about the influx of good arms into both leagues.
More hard throwers,
yes.
Well, I think that might be part of it in the National League, Mike. A lot of pitchers, well, let's say several pitchers in the National League are perhaps turning in better years than expected. And one that comes to mind is Tim Leary.
Yep.
With the Dodgers. There have been others. But I thought that was interesting. 290 gets you into the top 10 in the other league.
1-2 to Robin. Fought it off him and kept it fair. It'll be extra bases as Robin heads to second with a double. Boy, oh boy. Pretty good piece of hitting right there by Robin. We get a replay. Watch how he is able to keep this ball fair. He doesn't hook it. That ball inside, and he was able to shoot it right by the third baseman, Martinez.
He just turned on the Jets right out of the box, too. He had double all the way. He won't get enough at bats to hit for another cycle tonight. He has a home run and a double.
Well, let's hope not. That would mean we're probably in extra inning.
I know it.
But the way he hit that ball, Jim, where that pitch was located, the normal hitters, most hitters, are going to hook it foul. He was able to keep the head of the bat in fair territory.
What did he do? Did he keep his hands up a little higher?
Yeah, he really did. He didn't turn them over as quickly. Almost like he aimed it that way. Two balls, no strikes on Deer. Of course, we'll be with you tomorrow night along the Brewer Television Network. Also adding a game in Seattle Saturday night. So we will have all three from the Kingdom, 9 o'clock on Friday and Saturday night, and 3:30 on Sunday. That's Central Daylight Time. Ooh. Boy, right down on the foot of Robbie Deer. He wears that protective padding.
He needs something for the top of the shoe. He knows needs those steel-toed shoes.
trade with the umpire.
There you go. That foot has taken a beating all year long.
Two balls and a strike with Yount at second base, 3-1. We'll also have all three from California Monday night, Tuesday night, and Wednesday night. And those games will start at 7 o'clock, or make that 9 o'clock, 7 o'clock on the coast, but 9 o'clock in the central time zone. Robbie trying to hit it out of here, isn't he? Full count now to Deer. Up short right field, and Diaz makes the play. Ooh, Robin had to scamper back to the bag. That has been a trouble spot, hasn't it? Behind first base the last couple of nights.
Looked like we were going to see another quail in there. Diaz stayed with it. The wind blowing out of the west, it'll blow it in from the right field line, and it does, but Diaz stays with the baseball. And Robert, as Mike said, just back at second base.
Hey, for the life of me, I don't know why Manrique didn't call him off. It was an easier play. Usually, the guy with the angle will call if he can make the play, and Manrique just let Diaz make it himself, but it was a tough play. Jeffrey Leonard has struck out twice tonight. Hits this one. Base hit center field. Robin coming around, he will score, and the Brewers lead 3-0. So after striking out twice, Leonard with a big two-out base hit to scoring out right here.
A looping liner over Manrique's reach, quite a bit over his head, and Robin has no trouble scoring, no play at the plate, and the Brewers now lead 3-0.
Base hit number 6 by Milwaukee, and for Jeffrey Leonard, his 36th run batted in of the year. A ball to Brock. The Yankees have taken the lead from Cleveland. They lead 5-4. Toronto 9, Detroit 1. Boy, the Tigers having all kinds of problems. One to Brock, hit well, but right at Manrique. Big hop, he bobbles it, but recovers in time to throw out Brock and retire the Brewers in the 6th. But they come up with another run on 2 base hits. One man left. After 5.5, the score, Milwaukee 3, Chicago nothing, on the Brewer Television Network.
Right now, the only thing that would taste better than physical filter game. Yeah, if you want a beer whose real draft taste hasn't been changed by heat pasteurization, we've got it down cold. Cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft.
It's as real as it gets.
Farm and Fleet's fall catalog is filled with spectacular brand-name savings in every department. Give your car world-class protection with Pennzoil Premium Motor Oil. Now only $1.09 a quart for several grades. Cases are $12.69. Pennzoil PZL Turbo 10W30 is $1.19 a quart. Farm and Fleet is your AC Delco headquarters. AC Delco oil filters and air filters are priced from $2.99. AC Delco spark plugs are just 84 cents. Only in Farm and Fleet's Value Pack Fall Catalog.
Wow.
A new high-efficiency gas furnace that is so advanced it seems almost simple. The 9580GF from Tempstar.
In Milwaukee, call Joyce Heating and Air Conditioning. On the south side, it's Ralph's Heating. On the north side, it's Fueltronics Heating.
Read my lips. I'm not going to pay a lot for this muffler.
At Meineke, we install quality Everlast mufflers from just $18.93.
Coulters wants to win one for the Kids and Children's Hospital. Each time the Brewers win a televised game, Coulters will donate $100 to Children's Hospital of Wisconsin. A shutout brings $300, a no-hitter $500. We salute Coulters and the Brewers for wanting to win one for the Kids of Children's Hospital of Wisconsin. Nieves, two balls and no strikes to the leadoff hitter Dave Gallagher. Bottom of the sixth, Brewers leading 3-0. Gallagher has flied to center field and grounded into a double play. 0 for 2 tonight. Nieves has scattered two base hits. He has struck out two and walked two. And threw a pretty good fastball right there. Chuck Gartenstein and Tom Treblehorn keeping a watchful eye on Nieves. Ooh, just missed. 3-2. Hit in the air, short right field. Gantner going back. He will make the call and makes the play. One out.
Yeah, it is. It's an automatic call. It's an automatic call.
One out. That will bring Steve Lyons to the plate. Hartenstein, I believe, trying to establish some communications with the bullpen. Maybe the phones are out. Somebody call the phone man. Can't get him out there. Boston batting in the bottom of the eighth at Fenway, leading 5-4 now over Baltimore. So the Orioles have come back. I guess now the phone is fixed. Lyons fouls it back. Trip calling room service, I guess, huh? Or is that the joke hotline? He's laughing, whatever it is. Somebody must have told a good joke. What's the 900 number, Trip? Pitch from Nieves, misses high, one ball, two strikes. Haney's probably telling one of those stories on the phone. Either that or don't tell me Mo Drabowski showed up. Maybe Drabowski's on the line out there. Breaking ball gets him. Third strikeout for Nieves. He gets Lyons on a breaking pitch. Good pitch by Nieves. Remember, Drabowski used to do all kinds of things out in that bullpen. He'd call Japan.
Who got the bill?
Baines looks at a strike. Not Moe, that's for sure. Must have been a good joke. Hardy wants to hear it, too.
Yeah, they're spreading it around.
Well, you could do a whole Bob Newhart routine, couldn't you? Bob Schmidt from Milwaukee here tonight wants to say hello to his family back home. And I think they want the left-hander, I guess. Baines lines one to left field. Going back is Leonard, and he makes the play. Three up, three down in the sixth inning. So six complete now, and we'll have to find out what that phone conversation was all about. Brewers 3, White Sox nothing on the Brewer Television Network.
You'd never know by looking at Luke that he was born with a defective heart. When he was 10 months old, a Green Bay doctor referred him to Children's Hospital. Specialists at Children's Hospital diagnosed the problem and operated. Now he's healthy, happy, and full of the dickens, just like any other kid. When it's your child's health, we're right there.
Now you can avoid the high cost of hiring a professional plumber by handling many repairs yourself. With professional quality master plumber repair parts and fittings from True Value Hardware Stores. They come with step-by-step instructions for easy installation. And when you choose master plumber parts and fittings, you can be sure your repairs will last, because they're all quality constructed to resist corrosion and wear. Look for them exclusively at participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
Hardy's Garden Fresh Salads. We call them that because our lettuce comes from fresh lettuce. Our cabbage from fresh cabbage. And our carrots from, wouldn't you know it, fresh carrots. And now our freshest idea yet, zesty new chicken fiesta salad with tender marinated breast of chicken. Along with our chef and garden salads, it's a delectable thing we do to win you over.
15 dealers, over 3,000 cars and trucks, a car auctioned off every 30 minutes. They're back at County Stadium September 15th, 16th, and 17th, Wisconsin's largest car sale.
A new pitcher for the White Sox, Don Paul. P-A-L-L, Paul, 0-1 with a 3.54 earned run average, making his 14th appearance of the year. For Patterson, he went six innings. Gave up six base hits, three runs all earned. He struck out three and walked one. Gave up a pair of home runs. A home run to Molitor and a home run to Yount. Pitched pretty well other than those that shaky first inning. Clutterbuck and Bazio in the pen. Darrell Hamilton, the Brewer outfielder, wanting to pass along get well wishes to Mary Kay, who was in the hospital at County General. And we were going to do it last night, didn't get a chance to, but our audio man here in the booth, Paul Cullen, wanted to be remembered back to all the good folks at Derry's Pub in Milwaukee. He figures maybe he'll get a few free rounds when he goes back to Milwaukee, and he probably will now. So we go to the seventh. Joey Meyer, the hitter, and to call it, here's Jim Paschke.
Right back into that quail spot. Diaz back to retire him. One down here in the seventh. It'll pop up to the first baseman. This is our rally inning. And Kara Racine of Cedarburg is our contestant. Kara wins a Brewer warm-up jacket and a chance now at a VIP package if the Brewers score here in the seventh. Kara Racine, just like the city. Here's BJ with one down. Surhoff reached on a good bunt single in the fifth inning. That put Runners at first and second, and this one is foul. Good catch. Runners at first and second in the fifth inning. But Sheffield hit into a double play ball, and the White Sox got out of it without any run damage. Here's the 1-1. This one is through for a base hit. Surhoff 2-for-3 tonight. He is now 8-for-23 against the White Sox.
Boy, they really got BJ spread out up the middle, playing him on the infield on the right side like a dead pull hitter. He hits a lot of ground balls to the second baseman, but that time kept the hands back and drilled it right back up the middle.
So Gary Sheffield will bat with Surhoff aboard again. Ken Patterson went six innings tonight. He gave up three runs on six hits. Struck out three with a walk, two home runs. There's a base hit. Sheffield with a line drive single to left. And again, the Brewers have runners at first and second with one out.
You know, the thing about Sheffield is, Jimmy, he's a battler. He goes up there swinging. That's the kind of hitter he is. And so far, not a whole lot of success. But, boy, you know, when he hits the ball just jumps off his bat. He is so quick.
Last night, Jim Fregosi's White Sox made all the moves in the ninth inning and won. That was only their fourth victory after trailing through eight innings. Molitor, the hitter. Out of play. Paul led off the game with his 13th home run. He has grounded out and flat out in his two previous at-bats. The Brewers lead 3-0. They have out-hit the White Sox tonight, 8-2, a fine pitching performance by Juan Nieves, making his first start since mid-July. 0-2 now to Molitor. Well, Don Fall is 26 years old. He's a Chicago native, Evergreen Park. Graduated from Evergreen Park High School in 1980 and the University of Illinois in 85. Converted to a reliever last year. Fisk blocks that pitch. One ball and two strikes. Ball was 5-2 in Vancouver this year with a 2.23 earned run average. 1-5, says Treblehorn. That means something. It has been relayed inside. Two balls and two strikes. Could be two. Guillen Manrique Diaz. And again, the double play gets the Sox out of a tough spot. Runners on first and second with one out. The double play. And the Brewers' seventh is over. They lead the Sox 3-0 on the Brewer TV Network.